What's up, everyone? So today I'm down at Jaguar, Land Rover, Porsche, Volvo of Greenville, and behind me is a 2019 Volvo XC40. Huge shout out to them for providing this vehicle for me today. I'll have a link to this car and their website down in the description below. And the model that we're looking at today is the T5 R-Design. It's finished off in metallic white and has an MSRP just over $45,000. Is a 2-liter four-cylinder turbocharged engine. This is only paired to the 8-speed Geartronic automatic transmission with steering wheel mounted paddle shifters. This engine produces 248 horsepower at 5,500 RPM and 258 pound-feet of torque as low as 1,800 RPM. It is all-wheel drive, weighs around 3,600 pounds. 0 to 60 can happen just over 6 seconds, and with a fuel capacity of 14.2 gallons, you can estimate the MPG to be 24 in the city and 31 in the highway. The wheelbase measures 106.4 inches, it has an overall length of 74.2 inches, the width is 63 inches, and it has a height of 65.3 inches. The XC40 is now the smallest crossover SUV from Volvo, with two other models alongside the R-Design, the Momentum and the Inscription. Later this year, the T4 will be introduced with a smaller turbo and only front-wheel drive, and the diesel model and manual versions will not be coming to the States. Starting up front, this vehicle comes standard with LED headlights with automatic bending technology, along with LED fog lights that have a cornering function to them. Standard forward-facing camera is just under the Volvo logo right in the center, along with 6 parking sensors. The black grille is quite large, there's very nice lines running along the hood, and then a nice color contrasting black lower section of the bumper. Disc brakes are located in all 4 corners, and 19-inch wheels come standard. This vehicle offers the optional 20-inch, 5-spoke black diamond cut alloy wheels. The rear passenger doors have an upswept line to them, meeting the C-pillar and the roof line, giving it a very aggressive look with R-Design just behind that point. The side mirrors and the roof are metallic black, giving it a great contrast to the metallic white color. Both side mirrors have a camera just underneath them to help with the 360-degree camera. The side lines in the door are very distinct and give it a nice look from the side profile. And the trim pieces on this car are black to match the roof. There's also a nice color contrasting on the lower side skirt of the car. And finishing off in the rear with the integrated spoiler and third brake light, LED taillights come standard along with the backup camera and 6 parking sensors. The rear wiper blade is mounted on the lower section of the glass to improve visibility. This has a power liftgate, black color contrasting on the lower section of the bumper along with dual exhaust. And now with the key, we'll go ahead and take a more in-depth view of the interior. The key is wrapped in nice fabric. It has lock, unlock, and the power liftgate on one side and hazards on the other. And walking up to the vehicle with the key in my pocket, I just place my hand in the door handle. The power mirrors will fold open, all the doors will unlock. Inside, the door panel is finished off in a combination of black leather and orange lava carpeting. That carpeting runs the entire side of the door and all the way down into the lower storage compartment. All of the windows are automatic up and down with your side mirror adjustments, your lock and unlock. Memory seat adjustments with the aluminum release handle. If you'll notice, there is no speaker in the bottom section of the door. They have been moved to the center dash, which I'll show later. This has the optional Harman Kardon 13 speaker sound system. R-Design is down on the door sill. Then moving on to the seats, they have a combination of perforated and solid black nappa leather with white piping running along the upper portion and the headrest. Very nice bolsters with white stitching running along both sides. These have an 8-way power adjustability and 4-way power lumbar adjustability support. Along with being able to adjust the front portion of the seat, there's also a storage compartment located below that. There's more orange lava carpeting on the floor mats. There's also a little bit of storage space on just the driver's side. Once inside, we're greeted by a 3-spoked R-Design wheel that's fully wrapped in black leather, has more of the white stitching running along it. On the right side, we have your Bluetooth and radio controls. On the left side is all of your cruise control and distance pacing settings. There's aluminum accents running through the steering wheel along with the paddle shifters on the back side. On the left side of the steering wheel is your power tailgate release, a dimmer switch for the gauges. You have some slots here to hold some business cards. One air vent. Coming along the top is the speakers that have been moved from the door panels. And then moving back to the center gauge setup, this is a 12.3-inch digital display with your speedometer on the left side, your tach and gear selector on the right, along with the fuel gauge. A few more settings in the center there, you can see your time, temperature, and the navigation screen in the middle. And then moving on to the center 9-inch touchscreen navigation system with an air vent on both sides. Very easy to use, you swipe it just like you're on your phone. There's a center home button on the bottom side that brings you back here. You can go through multiple different settings, your Bluetooth again, your radio, driver performance, so you can look at fuel economy and things like that. There's heated seats in this vehicle and climate control buttons are in the middle, and then you can go back to your home screen again. And then to activate the rear camera, we're just gonna push on the center shifter twice to put it up into reverse. You'll see the camera light up. I'll click on 360. Four different cameras you can choose from. So there's the front camera. We'll go back and look at a side camera. So this is underneath the side mirror. Back to 360. This also has a park in and out feature for parallel parking. Underneath that screen, there's some more controls for the radio, your front and rear defrosters, along with a hazard switch. There's four different driving modes, and we just use that button on the right side to go between all four of them. Down below, there's a 12 volt with two USBs, along with a charging station and a good amount of storage space. Also a little cubby behind that. Leather wrap shifter with more white stitching. Pushing the P button will put it into park. Two cup holders along with the electronic parking brake. This button controls the engine start stop feature. Behind that is a trash can, and then we'll take a look at the center storage space. Has a good amount of room. The glove box also has a decent amount of storage space. There's also a pop-up hook that I forgot to mention. When you open that back up, you can easily hang anything you want from that, and then of course just hide it away if you don't need it. We'll take another look at the orange lava interior. It's also down on the carpets. Looks very cool against the black leather seats. This also has the panoramic sunroof. All of those buttons are up in the center, along with some emergency controls. Some more aluminum inlays run along the entire dash and on the door panel as well. And now we'll go ahead and take a look at the rear seating. The door panel again is finished off like up front with the orange lava carpeting. Looks really cool. Your aluminum release handle, your lock and unlock. There's some storage space on the outside of the seat, which is nice to have. And this is a 5-seater SUV, so let's go ahead and hop in. Behind both front seats, there's some netting with extra storage space. Two air vents in the center have a really cool design. You just twist the center to turn them on and off. A USB down below that. With the moonroof, the dome lights have been moved to each side of the door. With the front seat set at my height, 5'10", I have plenty of leg room, plenty of headroom as well. I'm not cramped in the back here at all. The center pullout has two cup holders in it. There's also a way to remove the middle in case you have anything larger to go through. Here's your view from the rear seats. Again, getting a look at the orange lava carpeting. Looks really cool inside here. And the seats also have a 60-40 split to them with a removable cover in case you have anything larger that you need to fit in here. And now we'll go ahead and take a look at the rear storage space, and I can either hold the button on the key fob or walk up to the vehicle, of course. The power liftgate will automatically open up. And with the seats up, this has about 20.7 cubic feet of storage space, about 47 with the seats down. This is that center portion that you can do by just by itself. There's a 12 volt on one side with a little bit of storage space on both sides too. This has a two-piece folding floor, so you can move this upwards. That way you have a divide between things in the back in front of that. You can also fold it completely down in the back to give you a little more room. And underneath the floor is a spare tire, but you can also put the cover down there as well to get that out of the way. And then we can just push on the button up top to close it up. Definitely a lot of storage space for this small size SUV. So getting the XC40 out on the road now, the first thing that I wanted to go over was the visibility. Since I've driven the two larger SUVs, being in the smallest one now, the visibility is not really compromised. I can easily see out of the rear glass, and while the C-pillar is a bit bulky, you can see out of the side glass over your left and right shoulder, along with looking out of the rear and then using your side mirrors. So while it is the smallest SUV from Volvo, visibility wasn't compromised. You can easily see all around. And the next thing that I wanted to talk about is, in researching this car, I actually found that Volvo designed this for millennials. They wanted this for the younger audience that wasn't quite starting a family just yet, but needed an affordable car. And also they offer Volvo Care with this car. So that's something that basically is like leasing a car, but it includes everything in one payment. So insurance, maintenance, any repairs, anything like that. You basically just pay one payment and the whole car can be taken care of. The one thing I really like about this car, and specifically on this spec, is the interior. When I first opened up the door and I saw that orange lava carpeting, it kind of shocked me. It's definitely cool to see it in person, along with the black leather seats. I really like the combination. It's something a little different, but it definitely works in this car. Moving on to the interior, everything is very premium feeling for this entry-level SUV. Everything is either aluminum, like you see on the steering wheel and on the center dash, or it's leather, like the steering wheel and, of course, the seats. But this definitely has a nice premium feel to it. It also has a very comfortable ride. I'm gonna go through the driving modes with you guys again. It has eco, comfort, off-road, and dynamic. Now, glancing down at that real quick, it actually said that off-road, not possible due to high speed. So I'm sure you have to be 10, 15 miles an hour for that. I'm not sure how many people would take this off-road, but it's cool to see that feature. Putting it into comfort, everything is very smooth. It softens up a good bit, and then I'm gonna switch it over to dynamic. You definitely feel it tighten up, so it's cool to have that option. Of course, you're not gonna take this out on any back mountain roads or things like that, but if you'd like to change up the suspension, you have the option to do that. The layout and the seating position in this car is really comfortable too. Just driving it a couple miles already. I like the center layout. It's really easy to read everything on that center screen with your navigation right in the middle. But the overall driving positioning is very comfortable. I like how the seat has the adjustment up front, so I can slide that out and kind of meet the back of my calf there, just to give me a little more comfort. The seats have a good bolstering on both sides again, so that just adds to the comfort of this drive. I could definitely see this being a comfortable daily driver. With this being a smaller SUV, you still have five seats, so you can comfortably put three people in the back, and then there's plenty of storage space even with the seats up. This also has all the standard safety features. You have your collision avoidance, your adaptive cruise control, lane departure, everything like that, all the settings that are coming standard nowadays. Coming up to a sharp turn right now, brakes do a great job. Doesn't have too much body roll. It only weighs about 3,600 pounds, so it's not really on the heavy side. And then coming up to a stop sign right now, it has the stop and go feature, so it'll shut off. You take your foot off the brake, back on the gas, it'll start up again. But let's go ahead and test out the turbocharged engine this has. I'm not gonna give it too much gas, but it definitely gets up and goes. You know, it's not slow for the 250 or so horsepower that it has. Definitely can get up and go. It's not too loud from the inside. So I've spent the afternoon with the XC40, and I can honestly say this is a really good entry-level SUV. It has a lot of standard safety features and interior quality features that you would see on much more expensive SUVs, probably SUVs that are twice as expensive as this. With all the aluminum inlays, the leather everywhere, the leather seats, very nice configurable center screen to use along with the digital display and the gauge cluster. And now we'll take one last look from the passenger side. Very cool to see this orange lava carpeting everywhere, even the floor mats. Definitely has a cool design against the black interior. More of the aluminum accents, nice pattern on them running along the inside as well. Another look from the passenger seats. I have them folded down so you can get this perspective with my backpack there. Definitely plenty of room. You can store anything in here that you need. So that is my walk around review and test drive of the 2019 Volvo XC90. Huge shout out again to Jaguar, Land Rover, Porsche, Volvo of Greenville for providing me with this SUV for today's video. This is the smallest SUV from Volvo now, and on this R-Design spec with the black interior against that orange lava, definitely a very nice spec. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, smash that subscribe button. I will see you guys next video.